in there a servant, faithful, and do God's bidding? How can you tell what's going on? And some people say, well, our pastors are pretty good champions. I know some of us. I don't know if I'd call myself a champion. Some would say Billy Graham was a champion for God. So how can we tell what champion is? Or better yet, how about this? How can you move a mountain and don't say a dynamite? You remember what Jesus told us long ago? He said, because you have so little faith, I tell you the truth, if you have a faith as small as a mustard seed, you can say to this mountain, move from here to there, and it will move. Nothing will be impossible for you. And so I started reading the scripture, and I realized, you do not have to be what we consider great champions for God. We don't define who the champions of the Lord are. God does, right? God's the one who calls us into action, and I would argue that anyone who holds Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior is a champion for the Lord. You don't have to be a Billy Graham. You don't have to be a Martin Luther King. You don't have to be all these great people we look back and say, wow, look amazing they were. You don't have to be Elijah. You don't have to be Peter. You have to have a faith as large as a mustard seed, and you can live on that. I don't know if any of y'all have ever seen a mustard seed, but the mustard seed most likely Jesus is talking about is the black mustard seed, and it is itty bitty. It is maybe 2 millimeters in diameter. It is not very large at all. It is one of the smallest seeds you can plant. And if you plant, tune in Wednesday night, we discuss this. You plant this itty bitty little seed, and it can grow up to 8 feet tall and look like a tree. How amazing is that? How powerful is that? This itty bitty little seed can grow to be so amazing and immaculate. And Jesus says, if your faith is that size, that so tiny you can't see how close my fingers are together, you can move a mountain. You don't have to be Billy Graham. You don't have to be Martin Luther King. You don't have to be all these other great champions of recent years. For God, you just have to be you. And trusting in the Lord and having your faith, and therefore you can move a mountain. I've heard so many times of so many people, who am I to really be able to do these great things? And I'm like, well, you're nobody. Who's Billy Graham but a man? Who was Martin Luther King? But it was with their faith in God they were able to move mountains. Martin Luther King believed in God and the true message of the Constitution of the United States so much, and the rights that God gave us to be human, that he went out there and told everybody that he had a dream. And it's one of the most memorized and memorable moments in our history. Billy Graham established a legacy of faith and reading that so much of people use him as an example of how we should be as Christians. But they were mere men. They were nothing without their faith. And with their faith, they were able to move mountains. One, to save countless lives, the call of Jesus Christ. The other, to save countless lives for equality. How amazing. How truly powerful a faith of a mustard seed could be. I would like to imagine that they both had faith larger than a mustard seed. I would say they probably did. But wow, what did they do? How humbled they often were in front of others talking about God and the glories of others. Billy Graham had the potential to be this mega multi-million dollar minister, didn't he? Everybody knows him. He's so famous that he's putting a country song He didn't talk about his own success. He didn't talk about what he wanted for his personal self. He talked about others. And so Jesus comes to us and he says, you don't have to be these amazing people. You don't have to be the great warrior David who defeated Goliath. We done talked about David's flaws before, what he did. In today's standard, he wouldn't be considered a very good man, now would he? He committed adultery and then killed her husband. We don't have to be Moses, great and mighty Moses, who brought Egypt to his knees, and yet he's the one who not only committed murder before he ran the axe out of the desert, but also doubted God so much that God had given him an assistant. We've part of this, so y'all forget, Moses didn't want to talk in front of the Israelites. He was scared to death. And he kept arguing with God until finally said, fine, God said, fine, your brother can do it. You see, it's not the men who were great. It was their faith that was great. And that's a true distinction that we must make. Who are you? What's that song say? I'm just a nobody. Trying to tell everybody all about somebody saving my soul. I'm nobody. I'm nobody special. I don't have any unique gifts that you don't have. I just have the faith that God will guide me to say what needs to be said so that you can hear his message and hopefully grow closer with him. And maybe, just maybe, somebody will be saved through my teachings. But who am I without my faith? Just a nobody. My faith? Well, that's even more interesting because I'm still just a nobody. But now I'm trying to tell everybody all about somebody who's saved. Oh, I guess I'll be dead. None of my faith. Because it truly speaks to the message that these two men had. Who am I? Special. God is great. God is good. And God is so powerful that if our faith is as strong as just a teeny little mustard seed, we can move a mountain. We can change the world, is what Jesus is saying. Now, many people will take this literal statement. Now, you know what? Jesus could have been literal, but I think he was being more metaphorical in this moment. When he was saying you can move a mountain, what he was saying is, with your small faith, you can change the world. Just look at good old Saul, who became Paul. Look what his little faith did. He hated Christians, he persecuted Christians, had many of them killed. And then Jesus said, I'm going to use you to change the world. And Saul saw the light and saw the conviction of Christ. And so he took his small little mustard seed and he started planting it all around the Mediterranean and developed these churches all around that area. In Corinth, he planted a church, right? Wrote to them twice. He planted that seed, and he changed the world. He became one of the most influential people. And this was a man who did ungodly evil to Christians and ended up being someone who changed the world, who moved mountains for God. Never think that your faith cannot have an effect on the world. Because that is a lie. Because Jesus told you your faith can move mountains. Your faith can literally change the world. Your faith can change someone's life, and therefore that life can change someone else's life, and that faith changes someone else's life. But it started with the seed that you planted years ago. And now you have hundreds, maybe thousands of new converts to Christianity because of your faith. something even larger. If we allow that mustard seed to grow, and how powerful our faith can be. If a mustard seed can move the mountain, what if we allow that to turn into the largest mustard bush ever? Plant. Most people call it a mustard tree. That's not technically true, but we'll call it a mustard tree because it's easier to say. Big 8 foot tall, largest garden plant that you can have, right? What if we took that size faith? What could we do? Man, we could move whole mountain ranges, couldn't we? You see, the message Jesus is saying is that even people with little faith, wow, they can do amazing things. Do you remember when Jesus walked? Peter did. He said, Lord, if it is you, call me up there to you. He had so much faith. He said, let me walk on water with you. And Jesus said, come on. And what did Peter do? Everybody says, well, he sank. He did, but first, he walked on water. Such was his faith. And Peter is the one that many people say he's one of those show-me Christians. He's the one that always wants to be the first one there. He wants to be the one being recognized. He wants the one Jesus praises. And yet he was probably the most doubtful out of all the disciples. He was probably the most insecure out of all. If you go back and study all his reactions, it always seemed like he was trying to get Jesus' attention. Look at me, Jesus. I'm so... And it would seem like he had a serious issue with his security and relationship. And yet his faith was so strong, he was able to walk on water until he lost his focus. As soon as they take him out, they threw new people in there. The lions ate them. And yet, throughout his story, he always says, it's not me, it's God. It's not me, it's God. God is the one who allows me. God told me the interpretations of your dreams, O King. God is the one who saved me from the lions, O King. It is God's will. So who are we to serve God? We are nobody. But with our little bit of faith, we can still move a mountain. How truly amazing and powerful is that message? Can you move a mountain? Absolutely. Will you try? Probably not. See, it seems so unreal, but have a little bit of faith, walk up to a big old thing of rocks, and say, hey, move, you're in my way. And expect it to move. It seems so unreal that our daily lives, random acts of kindness, that we can actually have on someone's life. I was kind of reminded of this. I never really thought I was an amazing teacher. And I remember a couple years ago, back when my brother was principal at a certain middle school, he had trouble keeping a particular assigned position open. And they were just a couple weeks away from fall break before he could really hunt down somebody he wanted to be able to get to stay. So he gives me a call. Josh, I know you don't want to teach, but I want you come in just for 2 weeks. 2 weeks, can you please help me out? And so I find somebody to take this position. I said, all right, I'll help you out. I'll come in and teach you 2 weeks. And I taught for 2 weeks. picked on each other, they bullied each other, they tried to bully me, and then I told them I didn't care. And then they realized they had no power on me. But what was funny is I was only there for 2 weeks. 10 days is all I talked. This past Sunday, shopping for furniture. Young lady showing us all the different pieces of furniture. She kept giving me a weird look. Of course, we have the mask on, so it's, you know, kind of hard to recognize. I'm about to die in there because, you know, I don't like wearing that mask, and that heat comes back in my face, and I have breathing issues anyways because I'm fat and all this different stuff. And so finally, I was like, I got to take it off for a second. And I could see the moment of recognition across her face. She looked across the store. And I was like, all right, my buddy there, we'll put the mask on. Took a couple of deep breaths, put it back on. She walks up, and she goes, "Didn't you teach 8th grade science at this school?" I was like, I didn't even remember I did. I was like, "No, I taught 7th grade." She's like, "No, it was 8th grade." I said, "8th grade, I had you as a teacher." And she told me she just graduated this past summer, and I was like, "Huh, oh, that was when I substituted. I was in there for just 2 weeks for it." She goes, "Yeah, I remember, I thought that was you." And she talked about how she enjoyed having me as a teacher for 2 weeks and 10 days. I was with her for 10 days, and yet I had an impact where she remembered me 5 years later. How humbling of an experience this was, to have an impact on someone random. And she said, basically, I brought a little bit of structure and desperate to meet him. It was the first time all that year she had learned anything in science. Well, that wasn't hard to do because I didn't teach you a whole lot. And she just laughed, and then we ended up buying a new couch, and now I'm poor again. But it was truly a humbling experience. 10 days of this girl's life I was part of. And it was a pleasant memory at that, which was even more surprising. Don't think your small little mustard seed is insignificant. Don't think that you are so insignificant that God can't use you to change the world. You know, there was a story before that I Have a Dream speech. But Martin Luther King and several other men who were leading the marches and the protest, you know, and trying to get equal rights, they were debating on who would go up there. And he didn't want to do it. He thought he wasn't worthy to speak to all these thousands of people. And they said, "You're the best and most spoken person." And they all agreed he was the most passionate and most spoken of the group, and that he should do it. So finally he agrees to do it. And he goes out there and gives the most memorable speech in human history. It's right up there with what, the Gettysburg Address? I mean, it is a very memorable speech. And yet he was humbled in saying he wasn't worthy. You ask Billy Graham about all the success he has, and he goes, "I didn't have any success. It was for the glory of God." Their mustard seeds had grown into something so powerful and amazing that they're still remembered to this day as great men and champions for God. Don't think your mustard seed means nothing. And I'm sure if you read more about their story, there'd been someone who planted the seed, right? There'd been someone who inspired Martin Luther to do what he did and have his faith and conviction. And there was someone who inspired Billy Graham, and there's someone who inspired them. And your mustard seed can continuously change the world. But you have to have faith that it can. Who are you? Well, you're nobody. But with the faith of a mustard seed, you can change the world. That is the glory of God. That is the power of God that instills in you that just a little bit of faith, the impossible. honest, I didn't remember that young girl's name. She remembered me, though. All because I was a nice teacher and I tried to do something good for those kids. The most humbling experience I probably have had in a long time, it happened just yesterday, literally less than 24 hours ago. I was truly amazed. I know, it made me drop stuff too. So when you go out into this world and you try to follow the Lord's path, and you say, who am I to do this, God? Well, who was Moses? Who was David but a shepherd? Daniel saw visions. Samson was just a big buff guy. Peter, the fisherman. Child of God, and through your faith you can move mountains. And yes, it is the glory of God that shines